Let's all play What's My Line?
Well, hello, everyone. My gracious, it's Friday. I tell you, I never seen, you should pardon the expression, such a gamey panel. One is a full house and the other is a chessboard. You are adorable, both of you.
Yes.
Chic and elegant and really quite lovely.
And a gambler's delight.
Oh, ain't it the truth? Before we all eat our hearts out, would our first challenger enter and sign in, please? Charles Gregory.
Well,
where are you from, sir?
Roseville, Michigan, a suburb of Detroit.
All right. Charles Gregory plays music on a rather unusual instrument. We will now show the instrument, what it is he plays music on, or on what he plays music. And we'll start the questioning with Phyllis George.
You play on it. In other words, you don't... Like, I'm correct in assuming you don't play the spoons, right?
I don't play the what?
The spoons?
No, I don't.
That's right. You are correct in assuming that.
Okay. This product that you play on, is it something useful?
Something very useful.
Yes.
Can I just make a guess right off the bat? This
All
is
right.
Friday, you know. Hey,
why not?
Do you play a washboard?
A washboard?
No.
It's useful to a lot of
it
people
sure
in
is.
Africa.
Tony?
Does this have another, this instrument that you play?
Yes.
It has another use other than...
It has another use.
Right. And does that use involve something having to do with making contact with the body?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Arlene.
What were you thinking of, a comb?
Comb. Toothbrush and comb.
Is this an instrument that might not be seen in the Philharmonic?
You're correct.
Is it an instrument that is made out of a utensil that we have all seen?
Yes.
Is it an instrument that you can drink out of?
No.
No. I can only tell you this, Arlene. The only reason that you wouldn't see it at the Philharmonic is that John Gage doesn't know about it, probably. Henry?
Is it in any... they used to play saws. So, is it in any sense of...
Well, I play a saw, but it's not it.
You don't get sore.
Right. I wouldn't have brought it up.
Four down and six
no,
to go.
No, there's nothing down. I said they used to play saws, right?
Right, and then he stopped there.
Right.
Right, so, all right.
I'm sorry.
Well,
is
right.
It in any sense a tool?
Yes.
I guess you call it sort of a tool.
In a manner of speaking, it is a tool. It is an implement.
A implement.
Right.
Is it ever used around the house?
Yes, it is.
Is it used mainly in the kitchen?
No, hardly.
Will you accept a no gracefully, Henry?
Yes.
Phyllis?
Is this instrument, I'm trying to think of the size of it so we can go from there, is it smaller than a bread box?
It's larger than a bread box.
Five down and five to go, Tony. Wouldn't it have been funny if he played the bread box? Tony?
Do you use...
It's possible.
You use your hands in playing this instrument, am I correct?
I sure do.
Do you also put any part of the instrument in your mouth?
No, I don't.
Six down.
I know what it is.
Arlene?
I can rule out a garbage can.
Yes. You can rule out the garbage can.
Is it an instrument that ever contains anything?
Yes.
Yes, it contains, yeah.
If one had it in the house...
Yes.
Would one have it in a room... no. Would one have it in a room that might be on the first floor?
Could be.
A room other than the living room?
Could be.
Oh, would you have it in a game room?
It's possible.
You mean it's something to play in the game room? You should pardon the expression.
No, it isn't anything like a... Would it be a plumber's tool?
No.
7-3 to go, Henry.
Does it have a motor in it?
Yes, it's got a motor in it.
Don't get sore.
This, it's
like, between Charles and Henry's like frickin' frack.
You said contain in a funny way. So put the funny way containing, thinking of like dust, is it a vacuum cleaner?
Yes, it is. A vacuum cleaner. How did you discover that the vacuum cleaner was a good instrument?
Well, I'm an old vaudevillian. I'm a one-man band. I've been all over the world, and I just added it to my list of props.
What other instruments do you play?
Bicycle pumps, vacuum cleaners. I'm the first one to play a theremin.
Oh, really?
I played this at the Capitol Theater with Eugene Normandy conducting me. Years ago.
I didn't realize that was you.
Yeah, and I played the musical saw as an artist, too.
Is there any kind of special vacuum cleaner that you need to do this, or will anyone?
Anyone
works?
Will do.
Okay, now, what is this? Is this the instrument that you use to attach to it?
This is part of the vacuum cleaner. It's a radiator tool.
All right, fine. Could we open the curtains? Jennifer, would you bring out our magic vacuum cleaner? Here it is. And now, as he attaches the... Thank you, Jennifer. As he attaches the magic radiator tool to the vacuum cleaner, he's got it on, the orchestra's tuning up, and he will now play Ah, Sweet Mystery of Life. What's My Line? It's terrific.
Thank you.
I love the way he steps into the high notes. There's just a tiny little step where he gives it his high. Is that really? Would our next challenger enter and sign in, please? William Willard. Where are you from, sir?
St. Louis, Missouri.
St. Louis, Missouri. All right. William Willard manufactures a product panel, and we will now show the audience what that product is. And Henry, since you were such dynamite on that last one, let's start the questioning with you.
Gee, I'm exhausted, though. I got to work up to another one. Is this product something that is used by most... both men and women?
Yes.
Is it edible?
No.
One down and nine to go, Phyllis.
Are you married?
Yes.
Very cute. No, I'm kidding. Okay. Is it beneficial? Useful?
Yes.
It is useful.
Yes.
Are you referring to marriage or his product?
Don't get smart with me there. Okay. It is useful. Is it some product, and is something that is product? Do you wear products? Is it something that is connected to your body in any way?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Tony.
I'm sorry. Was the question asked, was it edible? Did someone ask?
Yes, and it was not edible.
And it was not edible, right. Is this something that would be found in the home?
Yes.
Would it be found in any particular room? Well, that's a bad question, isn't it?
No.
Not necessarily.
Is it found in any particular room?
No.
I'll never speak to it again. It's the end of a friendship.
Arlene?
If one had it in one's home, would it be out where someone could see it?
No.
No. Henry?
That's a funny kind of sneaky thing, that product. Do you keep it in a drawer?
Could?
Yes.
Could?
Or a closet or out of the way, right?
Yes. Could?
Then, since it's a... you take it out, or I gather, only to use it to serve some purpose.
Possibly, yes. Yes.
Yeah. Does it have any moving parts?
No.
Five down and five to go, Phyllis.
Both men and women use this. Would I use it every... Would I use it?
You should.
I beg your pardon, I think. Would I use it on a day-to-day basis?
No.
Six down and four to go, Tony. When you say use it, did you mean apply to yourself?
Yes. No.
Tony?
Well, would I be different in some way physically as a result of using this, or would eventual use of this change me physically?
No.
No.
Oh, I'm awfully glad.
Arlene?
Now, Mr. Willett, you say it does not come in contact with the body in any way. Is that correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
But it has no usefulness while it is in the drawer or in the closet, does it?
Yes.
Does it keep the moths away?
Yes. Hey.
What is it?
Those mothballs?
Mothballs is what the man makes.
He is vice president
of Irwin Willard Company of St. Louis, Missouri, makers of mothballs. What do moths eat, he asked.
Moths eat everything. Clothes, all your clothes. New clothes.
Old clothes.
Old clothes.
Is there any particular fabric that they're partial to?
Wool, but they eat the synthetics also.
Do they now?
Yes, which some people don't think they do, but they do.
Have they, is that a new strain of moth that does that? Did they now have developed a tolerance for...
We developed the moth.
You mean by introducing those fabrics?
Yes.
I see. Or do you mean your mothball company developed the moth?
Yes. That's...
What does a mothball do besides make everything smell like mothballs? What does it do? I'm not putting them down. Everybody's got to have them. But what is it that they really do? How does it attack?
The mothballs?
Yeah.
The vapor actually kills the moth. But it, larva is what makes the holes in your clothes. The actual moth flying around doesn't do it. But the mothball kills the eggs that the moth lays.
I see. I didn't know that. I always thought we'd get the moth. I always wonder why I didn't see any moths lying around from that thing.
Or any fat moths.
Or any fat moths. Some comedian once had a line where he said, you know, we were so poor when I was a kid that the moths used to come out of the closet yelling, whoa, whoa. Thank you very much for being with us on Once More Line. Okay, panel, you're really hot today. It's time for the special feature of What's My Line, the appearance of our mystery guest. It's blindfold time. Are all the blindfolds in place?
No.
Would our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? All right, panel, we'll go one question at a time. You have 2 minutes, and we'll start with Arlene Francis.
Well, they all know you. Is it because of your appearances on television?
Yeah.
I hope you feel better.
Henry?
Are you a part of a series?
No.
Phyllis?
Are you involved in comedy?
Not intentionally.
Tony?
I think I'd like to guess someone from my show. I always get stumped on that. Are you in a Broadway play right now?
No.
Arlene?
Are you a singer?
Yeah.
Henry?
Do you usually work out of California?
No.
Phyllis?
You can assume you usually work in New York. Or Las Vegas. Las Vegas.
Which one are you picking now?
Oh, I haven't decided yet. No. Las Vegas.
Oh, do you work in Las Vegas mostly?
Occasionally.
Tony?
Are you what could be considered a rock singer?
No.
Arlene?
Are you singing at a club in New York at the present time? Or
no.
A room? No.
Henry, you've got about 15 seconds.
Are you basically a ballad singer?
Yeah.
Phyllis?
Basically a ballad singer. You said, so when you sing, do you involve a little comedy with your nightclub act?
No.
Tony?
No, I didn't mean that at all.
Oh-ho.
Oh, have you ever sung with a group?
No.
I tell you, our time is up, and we want to have a chance to chat for a minute before we leave, so would you take off your mask? This is Julius LaRosa. Well, you're something, Julius. That was a voice that they just couldn't get.
I didn't know what to do. I didn't know whether I should do a voice or not, and finally I said
you know, I have a show on WNEW, and have had it for a number of years.
Yeah, it's about 4 years now. I'm doing the disc jockey show, radio show here in town. And
Do you enjoy it?
I love it.
What's new? You know, you're really right there with everything that's happening with music now. What is happening? Where's it going? Where's it been?
It seems to be we're going to what we used to call good music, and you take a song, O.C. Smith just came out with that, Don't Misunderstand, this is... They wrote those songs in our day, so to speak. Yeah. So I think, really, there is a trend toward what we used to call the better music, which is not to say that today's music is not good music.
No, but it'll be nice if we can all hear that melody again.
Oh, yeah. Well, that's what I miss more than anything else.
Yeah. And hear that trumpet. And hear that LaRosa. Julius, thank you for
Larry, thank you. Good to be here.
Okay.
Nice to see you.
Okay, we're back, and would our next challenger enter and sign in, please?
No?
We really are back. There she is. Cora? London.
Hi, Cora.
Where are you from?
Manhattan.
All right, panel. Cora London is a barber, an actress, a hairdresser, and a portrait painter, but that's not why she's here. She has another occupation in which we're interested. She performs a service and will show the audience what Cora's fifth line is. Oh. And we'll start with Tony Roberts.
I understand we have very little time, so what do you do? do you perform this service on men and women?
Yes.
On
them. Oh, yes.
On
them?
Well, not on.
Well, I meant for them or to them.
That's all right.
Since you do this to them, is it necessary for them to be in any particular position? That is, must they be prone rather than erect?
Whichever.
One down and nine to go, Arlene.
I'm not even going to ask you what you had in mind.
Lying down!
Is your service something that makes a first person feel or look better?
Sometimes.
Well, not it does, but you wouldn't think of it as that, and I wouldn't mislead you with a thing like that, Henry.
Oh, when do people come to some place of yours to have this service performed?
It's hard to tell, Henry. Sometimes they do, and sometimes they don't.
All right, I'll take a yes on that. Now then. All right, I'll give you a real out no, right?
All
okay.
Right.
Could this be done by mail?
No.
By M-A-I-L. Three down and seven to go, Phyllis.
I have to disqualify myself, and I'll explain later.
All right, four down and six to go, Tony.
Yes, I'll have to disqualify myself. Do you, is it necessary, do you wear any special clothing when you do this?
No. Arlene?
Do you touch the person when you are giving this service?
No.
Six down and four to go. In passing sometimes, but not as part of the service. Henry?
Does it have anything to do with anything like or such as or in the area of fortune telling, astrology, tea leaf reading? No. Right, fine.
We're all out of time. I'm sorry to say she is a taxi driver.
Drive the car.
She took me, and two days ago, she was my driver. And I said, well, now, you know, some men have problems with loose women. I said, do you have any problems with loose men? And you said, no, they're great to me. Is this a small world?
Yes, isn't it?
It certainly
is. I remember you.
That's do right. you really?
Little girl came up here all the way from Denison.
Shucks, y'all.
And her first question to the cab driver was, do you have any trouble with loose men? It's hard to believe. Cora, thank you for being with us. Don't go away. Thank you for being with us, everybody. We'll see you next week. Goodbye. Have fun.
This is Chet Gould speaking for What's My Line, a Mark Rich and Bill Todman production. This crash is gowned by Bonwit Keller. This program was recorded.